is Tiani from P6EM, and today I'll be telling a story. The story is called Willy Buckhawk, written by Hilary Ling. I don't have the book, so I'll be telling the story with some of my printed out friends. If you have heard the story, please bear with me, stick with me, please listen to the whole story again. And if you haven't, then please enjoy. Yeah. But yeah. The story started out with Ladybug preparing for her day. It was a sunny day. She was ready to meet and greet her friends. And as she walked out of her home, she met her friend, the crocodile. The crocodile is the funniest out of all her friends. At first, Ladybug wanted to greet the crocodile, but she didn't know how to greet him or whether he would like the way she greeted him. So the Ladybug asked the crocodile, "Crocodile, can I hug you?" And the crocodile replied, "Yeah, sure, you can hug me." And so they hugged each other. Because of the crocodile's long snout, they cannot hug in front to front, but only side to side. After hugging the crocodile, Ladybug met another friend of hers, the bear. The bear is the kindest and most welcoming out of all her friends, despite his big body and sharp teeth. Ladybug asked the bear, "Bear, can I hug you?" And the bear replied, "Of course you can hug me." And so they hugged. Hugs from bears are always warm and comforting, not like any other, which is why it's specifically called the bear hug. After hugging the bear, the ladybug met another friend of hers, the sheep. Even though the sheep was as fuzzy and as warm as the bear, she was a lot more shy than everyone else. The ladybug asked the sheep, "Sheep, can I hug you?" And the sheep replied, "Sorry, I don't want to hug right now." Hearing this reply, Ladybug didn't force the sheep to hug her. She just nodded, waved at the sheep, and flew away. After leaving the sheep, she met another friend of hers, the frog, the most energetic and sporty animal she ever met in the jungle. Ladybug asked the frog, frog, can I hug you, please?" And the frog replied, yes, come on, let's hug together." And so they hugged. They were so happy hugging each other that they even jumped while hugging. While jumping and hugging together, the ladybug could see the giraffe giggling at them. The giraffe is the calmest out of everyone. She rarely gets mad. The ladybug then asked the giraffe, "Giraffe, can I hug you?" And the giraffe replied, "Sure, I mean, I don't mind." And so they hugged each other. The ladybug could only hug the neck of the giraffe, as hugging her face would be weird and might as well suffocate her, but that's wrong, and we're not gonna do that. After hugging most of her friends, they all gathered around to say their final goodbye. After gathering around, the ladybug then told them that she wanted a group hug. Everyone, most animals agreed with her, all except the sheep. So most animals, including the frog, the giraffe, the bear, and the crocodile, hugged each other. It was the tightest, warmest, and most funniest group hug they've ever felt. It was happy. They were fine with it. All except the sheep. The sheep was too shy and she didn't like people hugging her. And that's fine. We shouldn't force the sheep to hug anyone. It's her choice. And we can always do something else other than hugging because she isn't comfy with it. Ladybug felt bad because she's afraid that she might feel that she was left out. So the ladybug thought of an idea. She thought for a while, and she came up with a brilliant idea. She then asked the sheep, "Sheep, how would you feel if we had high five with you?" Hearing this, the sheep became so happy and replied, "Oh yeah, I want a high five. I'm fine with that." And so the sheep had a high five with everyone. Like the ladybug, the frog, the giraffe, the crocodile, and the bear. After saying their last goodbyes with each other, the ladybug then flew up away through the sky, leaving her friends. So, thing is, the ladybug likes to hug people as a form of hello and goodbye. But as much as she likes hugging people, she doesn't force them if they don't want to, like the sheep. There are other forms of saying hello and goodbye, like waving and high-fiving and handshaking, and a lot of other ways too. So yeah, I guess the moral of the story is to ask for a consent, you know, the permission of people before doing anything with them, even though they're so harmless, like a hug. I believe that this applies to anyone, everyone actually. Even if they're your sibling, your best friend, your student, or even your child, they still have the right to refuse, and you shouldn't force them to do something they don't want, even if it's so harmless, like once again, the hug. You can always do something else with them, like a kiss on the cheek, or tickling them, or anything else that you're fine with. So yeah, that's basically it. Thank you so much for listening to my story. Me and my animal friends will be missing you so much. I'll be seeing you next time. Bye!